Here we are, and we're about ready. Well, Joe, why don't you tell us what we're about ready to do?
We're about ready to launch on Maxx Force.
Yes, okay. And for those of you who don't know Joe, you better find out who he is, okay? So, Joe, you've obviously ridden it before.
I have. I got to ride yesterday.
Uh-huh. And how is it?
It's fantastic.
Yeah, and so since you were the one who designed this whole thing and put it all together in your head, and then now it's a reality and you've ridden it, is it exactly the way you thought it would be?
It's better.
It's better. Okay. It's better. Well, that's a good sign here.
Yeah.
So I'm about ready to ride it for the first time. Joe's ridden it already, what?
Three times.
Three times. So you might not get the same reaction out of him that you're probably going to see out of me once we launch this thing. But
it comes at you pretty quick.
Yeah. Well, that's right. So, well, I'm looking forward to it. So let's see here. It's getting tight. And like you say, it's getting hot here. And I don't know if it's just because the sun's coming up or it's because anticipation for this ride.
But
a little bit of each. Yeah, I guess so. I don't know how far out we're at. But anyway, Joe, just tell me a little bit about, you know, what surprised you the most about this coaster since, you know, it was all in your head originally and now you've actually ridden it. What is it that really...
I mean, the launch, I'd been on some similar launches, but this launch is pretty special. And then I would say the last maneuver surprised me. That was kind of like a bonus piece to fit in something else on this tight site, rather than just coming off the high-speed roll right into brakes, having the two-piece inversion to finish the ride off with the diving brake run. But it just gives a little nice bonus feature rather than launch hill brakes.
Right, well, because this is a pretty tight layout that we have here due to the restrictions of coasters on both sides of us and everything here, so it's a limited space you had to deal with. How about how smooth it is? Did that...
It's extremely smooth.
Okay, that's good to hear.
S&S basically reworked.
Oh, here we go.
The train, here we do that.
Okay, this is it, folks. So let's see what happens here. I can't
wait. You see the nice upside down floater exiting the dog tongue?
Oh, yeah.
You'll feel that. You'll feel weightless. It's not hang time. You go fast enough where it's a true zero G. And then it catches you in that 4G pullout before hooking the corner and going to the roll. But it's just a little nuance that you don't really appreciate until you're on it.
Yeah, well, I'm going to find out any second now. There it is.
In 23-24 seconds.
Oh my goodness. It's like, oh, why don't we have more space?
Well, if you have more space, then all the elements after that get slower and slower.
Yeah, that's true too.
So I kind of like that it's all in your face the whole time.
Yeah. How about a double launch? Go again.
Yeah. I wouldn't complain.
There was send a launch right I'd back have through, to be like, yeah, send us right back through the station again one more time. Oh, man, that was fantastic. Well, you've done a good job here, bud.
Glad you liked it.
Oh, yes, definitely. Well, Joe, thank you for the ride. I really appreciate it, man. And thanks for
coming
with
out.
Us. Yes, definitely.